Hi guys, this is Supriya Kabra here, Ambassador of Lajja, Director of Cosmic Consultants and Founder of Intrago. While we are all talking and completely shattered and scared and lot of confusions about Corona, here we thought to break a lot of myths and come up with some very well talk about on the wellness for coronavirus. How can we fight it right sitting at your home? So to break the myth, today we have Dr. Jinendra Jain with us of Vocal Hospital. We are very much thankful to you, sir, for being here with us, and actually telling us that what are the, homemade tips that we can actually follow to fight against all of this. So we really do not want you to tell us about hand wash and sanitizers, which is a lot talked about. And in fact, the watchmen are right now giving us the sanitizer before entering the building. So we really do not want that. But what we want is how immunity, and what exactly does immunity means to you?
If we speak about the immunity medically, so it is the biological form basically. So in all multicellular animals, if we talk about, so they have certain kind of system inside the body which fights with the foreign organisms, foreign infections, foreign pathogens. So if they enter into the body, our immune system reacts, it kills, it destroys the outside bacteria, viruses or foreign particles. So that is basically the immunity. And we all are having immunity to some extent. Then there are different types of immunity, or innate immunity, or acquired immunity, then passive immunity, active immunity. So there are so many things in the immunity, cellular immunity, humoral immunity. So it's kind of that.
Oh God, I never knew that, okay, there is so much to do with immunity. Yeah, whenever I had cold, all I was blamed about immunity. So I never knew, okay, immunities can be of different types. But then with that, doctor, so a common flu or your cold, and as I just said that your cold is a kind of viral infection, right?
Yes,
and yes. Some very severe diseases or very life-threatening diseases like HIV, Ebola is also one type of virus, right?
Right.
So if that is right, then what type of virus do we call corona as?
There are so many viruses in the environment. Corona was there, but it is new to us because it was not infecting human bodies till now. So now it is a new virus which we never knew about. It was not there. So it is unlike other viruses which were there. So it is a new virus. In fact, if we say like HIV, it has been just discovered 36 years back, I think in 1982 or 1983. So before that, HIV was also not known. So that time that HIV was a new virus. Now it is again a new virus, which we all are fighting with as of now, which is like SARS-CoV-2. The disease is COVID-19. So it is a coronavirus. It's a new virus. So new virus, they keep on coming. Although it's a rare thing, but they keep on coming. And viruses, there are thousands of viruses, influenza viruses, adenoviruses, rhinoviruses. They lead to different kinds of disease in different of population. Hepatitis viruses, AIDS viruses, herpes virus. We keep on hearing about all these viruses. So these are common viruses. But coronavirus, which is a very new one, and that is why it has been called as a novel coronavirus. And we all are, as it is a new virus, we, our body don't know about this virus. So we are not immune to this virus. So most of the people, they are not exposed to this virus. So our immune system doesn't know how to fight with this virus. So that is the real problem with this virus.
Oh, so on that note, what would be the quick tips that you would want to give to everyone, no matter what age, what gender that person is, that how do we build our immunity system or sustain our immunity system to fight against such kind of viruses?
it is very difficult to develop this the natural immunity against this virus unless we really get some infection kind of this. So our immune system learned, okay, this is a foreign body. I will produce these kind of antibodies or these kind of cells to kill this virus. So we our immune system has to learn to fight it, but it will need a lot of time. It needs years, months to years. Now to keep our immune system intact, to fight with this, we can as of now just have a good lifestyle. What we always say, healthy food, healthy sleep, no smoking, moderation in alcohol, plus a lot of vegetables, fresh salads, fresh fruits. These are the things what we can do, regular exercise. So these are the things what we can do to keep our immune system intact and strong. As of now, nothing much can be done beyond this. There are no specific food particles or food types which should be avoided, or there are food, not certain food particles, food items which should be taken, which should be taken for the to boost our immune system against corona. There is nothing proven as of now. Like people are saying, garlic, eat cinnamon, eat black pepper, they will improve your immune system to fight it. But these are nothing. It is just, there is no evidence regarding all these things.
Okay, so that is the fact. And why it has took on the non-vegetarians, that there's lot of reduction in non-veg items, and so how is that associated?
I didn't get you. The voice was breaking, man.
Right now, people are not eating a lot of non-veg, right? So why, as you just said, that there is nothing which has been proven as of now, that any food item is associated to this virus. So if that is the case, then why non-veg is right now not...
People can have, people do not need to change their food habits. If they are non-vegetarian, they can continue their non-veg food. If they are vegetarian, they can continue their vegetarian food. If they are vegans, they can continue their vegan food. It will not change the spread of virus infection to them.
Oh, okay. So is it that pure myth of not eating a non-veg?
It's a pure myth. So the people need not to change their food habits. If they are okay having vegetarian food, that is also okay. If they are okay having non-veg food, that is also fine. It will not prevent the coronavirus to spread by changing the food habits.
All right. And then is there any dietary or food supplements that you recommend for one to build in their immunity system?
As I told you just now that to build the immunity system, we always have to have good lifestyle, which includes the balanced diet, which contains proper carbohydrate, proper protein, proper fat, good amount of vitamins and minerals, which usually in general, most of the Indian Thailis have. Like we have one pulses, one roti or some other cereal in form of rice, then one green vegetable, one curd, or if some non-vegetarian food is there, so some chicken or egg or meat piece. So plus salad and fruits. So this is the balanced diet. So our diet should be always a balanced diet, which includes all the major and minor elements of the required diet. So these are the things if we follow, along with regular exercise and good amount of sleep, which is very important to boost up the immunity. So good amount of sleep, regular exercise and regular diet. Plus if in future, if we get vaccine, then that vaccine definitely has to be given to each and everyone. So these are the things which we can do to boost up our immunity against any virus or any pathogen.
Correct. So as you just said, in future, if we get any vaccines, right? But most of the people right now are feeling that even an antibiotic is going to, keep them away from any viruses or any infection. Is that right?
No. No antibiotic can kill the viruses. All the antibiotics are made only for the bacterias, which are the different pathogens than viruses. Yes, but if someone gets viral infection, so sometimes they get the secondary bacterial infection. That time the antibiotic works when the patient is having secondary bacterial infection. Unless the patient is having secondary bacterial infection, it is useless and it may be harmful to take antibiotics even.
Today's newspaper was talking something very interesting, that a paracetamol can be like replacing to ibuprofen. It was something like that. Is that right?
Paracetamol is an anti-inflammatory drug, along with the group of other drugs, including the ibuprofen, including diclofenac, which are the over-the-counter the drugs in India, just for using for fever, pain, and all this. But the paracetamol is a very safe drug. It actually used as just an anti-inflammatory. Anti-inflammatory means whenever the lot of inflammation which leads to fever. So paracetamol is a safe drug. It doesn't harm unless it is in overdoses. It doesn't harm to kidney. It doesn't harm to liver. And or most of the desired work, we can get it with the paracetamol. But if we add it with other drugs, which are of the same group, including ibuprofen, Combiflam, Ibugesic, which are there. So those drugs are, they have certain element of toxicity also, apart from their anti-inflammatory activity. So a patient who has already got some infection, we really don't want any other harmful effect other than the virus is keeping. So it is better to avoid unnecessary drugs, including ibuprofen, including diclofenac, or antibiotics, or any kind of other drug, just to treat symptomatically with the paracetamol, or sometimes anti-cold medicines, plus physical therapy, rest, that's it.
All right. So doctor, apart from just washing my hands and applying sanitizer, what is the best advice that you would want to give it to us to, you know, as a precautionary advice?
Precautionary advice will be what the government and the all people are really fighting with this. We have to isolate and quarantine the suspected and confirmed patients. Once we are in contact with the patient, we are definitely going to spread the infection. We are definitely going to get the infection. Because this infection, as you all know, it spreads from the droplets, and those droplets are produced with our, even on sneezing, while coughing, and those droplets we can directly transmit from one person to another. And in fact, those droplets, they just sit on the table, they just go and sit on the cloth, and then they remain there for some time or some days. Some person goes, touch that cloth, touch that table, touch that anything, and then when he touches this, and then this finger goes to the nose or eyes or mouth, the infection gets in. So that is why all these things are getting so much stress, that keep a distance of at least 1 to 2 meters, so that if someone is sneezing, you don't come directly into the contact with the droplet. Plus, even if knowingly or unknowingly we are keep on touching the things, so the once we wash the hands, the virus gets killed with the proper alcohol based sanitizers or the soap. But just like entering into the society or entering into the office, where it is not really required. And actually we have to use a lot of sanitizer. The people are using 1 drop, 2 drop sanitizer. That is not effective. The alcohol quantity should be more than 50 to 60%. Then the sanitizer quantity should be enough. It should cover the whole of your hand. Then the sanitizer should get dried before you are touching. So all these things are important for the hand washing.
That is so true. Somebody just suggested that drinking hot water may kill some bad bacteria or a chance of getting this virus. Is that right?
No, there is no evidence of saying that the drinking hot water will kill the bacteria. But yes, of course, everyone should be hydrated enough. They should keep on drinking the enough required water, even if it is hot and cold. That is around 3 to 4 liters water a day. It will definitely boost up your, it will keep you hydrated, and that hydration keeps your cells working in a proper way, which includes our immune cells also. So it's a kind of, you can say, it try to maintain your immunity to a certain extent. If you are dehydrated, definitely your immunity also down that moment.
And this food has nothing to do with cooked food or raw food, right? If I'm eating a salad, so should I eat or avoid, or should I only prefer cooked food?
Salads, if it is properly washed, we can definitely have it, because whenever we cook the food, the essential vitamins, which are temperature sensitive, they get destroyed. So if we are only eating the cooked food, we will become deficient in the vitamins. So we have to have some amount of raw food, but after proper washing the food with the baking powder or whatever proper washing things what we are using in the kitchen to wash the vegetables and fruits. So just after washing, we can have it.
Doctor, so how about the patients who are already suffering from some or the other disease? How are they going to protect themselves from this?
The protection guidelines for them are the same as for the healthy person. The only thing, because they are already suffering, so their immune system is little down, so it doesn't work against to in that much capacity to any pathogen, not only coronavirus. Even if they are getting some other flu virus, they respond differently than other population. So they are more prone to get more severe disease in comparison to other general population. Protection, yes, if they need whatever vaccine is there, like they are having, we are having vaccines against certain pneumonias, we are having vaccines against influenza. So at least they should get vaccinated for these preventable diseases. COVID-19 vaccine, once it will comes, they should take as early as possible, it becomes available in the market.
Lovely. And how much do you feel that people should panic right now?
The panic right now, it is, it's a disease which is really a bad disease. If we talk about science, the mortality about the disease, it's hardly 1 to 2%.
Correct.
But the infectivity of the disease, it's very high. And the biggest problem in this, that when the person is even asymptomatic, it means he has got the virus, but he is not running any disease. So at that time also, he is just spreading the virus. So we really don't know whom to isolate, whom to quarantine. And this is the biggest trouble with this virus. The asymptomatic person is spreading the virus like anything.
So before we end the entire session for today, what will be the quick round of tips or quick round of advices that you would want to give to the public in general?
Yes, obviously, we have to stress on the isolation. We have to stress on the quarantine. If some of our relative, some of our friend, some of our colleague, some of our neighbor is coming from the infected country, if he has been advised home quarantine or the quarantine into the quarantine facility, or he has been advised to isolation, we have to insist, definitely we have to insist that no, you are not allowed to come outside, because you are obviously giving this infection, spreading this infection to community which everyone is fighting to. That is the biggest challenge, and that is the biggest thing what we can do. Second, avoid the gatherings, avoid mass gatherings, avoid unnecessary travels. Even if it is required, try to maintain the distance. And if someone is avoiding the quarantine and all these, and if you know about it, we can even tell the authorities that this person has been advised quarantine, but he is not doing. Plus, at the personal level, we can always do the guidelines of the healthy lifestyles, which I told you, good diet, good hydration, good sleep, and regular exercise. Plus, no smoking at all. Because smokers, if they get this infection, they behave differently than the other population. So it is demoralizing thing for the smokers. So they should stop the smoking as early as possible.
I feel finally the mother nature is going to force. Maybe the entire world not to get into the bad habits, you know, which you as a doctor had been advising from decades and more. Yeah. And I'm going to shout it loud, guys, please hear it. No smoking is what doctor advised. Yeah. So I'm shocked and surprised to see that whatever is happening, doctors have to be on toes and still you're so calm and composed, speaking all about our wellness, taking well care about us. So I really can see that 18 years of experience speaking in you. Yeah, you're so calm and composed and telling about what should be done by us to take care of ourselves. We also wish you and all doctors in the world to stay healthy, stay fit, and really, really, really thank you for coming in, telling us some real fruitful things. And I believe now after that, people are definitely going to come back home and practice eating at home, you know, instead of eating street food daily. I'm sure iske saath mein work from home to sahi, eat at home bhi shayad sir zyada promote ho jayega. And maybe that may not be a very great news for all the females out there. They'll have to cook it daily.
We all have to go out. But as of now, this is the necessity of time to be at home as possible, not to travel. So if everything is over in next few weeks or few months, we can go back to our normal lifestyle. But again, the basic lifestyle pattern which is going since years and years, hundreds of years, with the real education to do the healthy lifestyle, simple lifestyle, that will prevent you automatically from so many diseases.
Wow. Thank you so very much, sir, for spending such a great time for us. Like, I really, really appreciate we just approached and within 24 hours, we are here. We're talking to you. And thank you really so much for your time, for this great pieces of advice. I would insist all our viewers to please, please, please adhere to what sir has just said. So, doctor, thank you so very much for your piece of advice.
Thank you very much, Supriya. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye.